Looking to transmute some unwanted cards into a booster box? Look no further than ChannelFireball.com's online buy list. We offer competitive prices on cards from Ancestral Recall to Zombie Master, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you're not looking for cash, we offer a 30% store credit bonus. Head to ChannelFireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order. It's faster and easier than winning with a pack rat.
Alrighty, welcome to a modern event here on Channel Fireball. I've decided to record with EFro's twin deck from Grand Prix Minneapolis, Inferno Twin. Well, let's just be clear, he actually didn't play this list, but I keep saying he did, so I'm going to record a video assuming that was the case. In reality, he played a twin deck with main deck Twisted Image because the card's just very good. Kills Spellskite, which is a huge problem for the deck, then kills Wall of Roots, Noble Hierarch, plenty of things from Affinity like Ornithopter and Signal Pest. But I joked in my article that he was playing main deck Inferno Titans and Anger of the Gods to beat Melira, but I decided to make that deck just to see how it goes. So I'm calling it EFro Twin, though. This is a slight exaggeration of what actually happened. It is a twin deck. It's got one more land than normal because it's got main deck Inferno Titans. It's got just the four twins and the Kiki with six total Pestermites slash Exarchs, though Kiki Jiki Inferno Titans also kind of unbeatable. And then it's got Twisted Images and Serum Visions as cantrips with Remand as Disruption, then Bolts, one Anger, because I said there was an Anger, and Electrolyze, and then the third Cryptic since I'm playing another land. Sideboard has Ancient Grudge against Affinity, potentially Spellskite too. One Spellskite because I like it in some of the matchups, like against Boggles or the Mirror. Some counter spells like Negate and Dispel against Control decks. Blood Moon because there's a bunch of decks that get hosed by Blood Moon. Batterskull, because it's awesome to have Batterskull and Inferno Titan just be blue-red control against a lot of decks. The second Anger and Explosives as Sweepers, and then a Slash and a Lava Mancer as extra removal, with a Relic of Progenitus just in case. I'm in a daily event. Let's see how this goes. I would like to play first. Alright, I'm not going to mulligan this. This hand is not insane, but it's got Serum Visions in a Snapcaster Mage, which is nice, though obviously not a turn 2 Snapcaster. And, with a bunch of Cryptics in hand, it can kind of play the control role. I wouldn't mind, you know, keeping a land here. So, I definitely want... So I drew a land, so I have a third land no matter what. The question is whether I keep one or both of these cards. I'm actually fine with keeping both. I'm going to keep the Serum Visions first. So next turn, I'm going to Serum Visions into an island and see how that goes. And depending on what I'm playing against, if my opponent plays like a one drop or something... Yeah, see, if my opponent's got Steam Vents, I definitely want that land. If my opponent played a 1-drop, I could crack Scalding Tarn first to shuffle away the island. If I needed, like, a Lightning Bolt or something. I don't think I want... Actually, Misty's fine and Snapcaster's fine. Play land, pass the turn. Next turn, I'll just keep Serum Visioning into land because I've got a bunch of Cryptics in my hand. And if I'm playing against the Mirror, having more land is actually pretty good. If I'm playing against Storm, well, that's less exciting. Alright, let's see if I get remanded. And if Snapcash gets remanded, not a big deal. And if Serum Visions gets remanded, you know, also not a huge deal. Looks like Serum Visions probably is. That's okay. Still just a 1-for-1. Alright, so I've got 5 lands. I actually can start putting lands in the bottom. And actually don't really want Lightning Bolt either. I think getting my Snapcaster, you know, past... random creatures is not really how this game's gonna work. Alright, now I kinda wish I had the Lightning Bolt, but this is fine too. I get clicked here, so still could, I think it's most likely the Mirror here, just because it could be Delver, but I don't know how likely that is. Alright, Exarch's not a horrendous draw. I still think I'm just gonna Snapcaster here and just cast more Serum Visions. Because Serum Visions is sweet. Alright, drew a land, then drew an Inferno Titan. Great. Alright, don't need the land. Actually, I think Pestermite is okay, because Pestermite can trade for Vendilion Click, since I have a spare Exarch here. Yeah, this is definitely the Mirror. Alright, getting bashed. So now I've got to be... Now that my opponent's passing with a bunch of mana up, I actually do have to be worried about getting comboed out here, so keep that in mind. Opponent's not going to cast... a twin or Exarch, or rather Exarch or Pestermite, probably right into Serum Visions here. The question is, do I cast just Pestermite and Deceiver here? Since, well, let's stop on my end of turn step, let my opponent resolve Desolate Lighthouse here, and I'm gonna do my thing. I guess I'll just get a mountain here, since I have Cascade Bluff, so I'm looking pretty good regardless. So I think it's worth doing this because the mirror doesn't really have a great play to play on this turn. Like, they can't tap out for anything insane. So I think just casting my two things and having Cryptic up is worth it. Ooh, let's untap a Steam Vince. And pass the turn. Since now, if my opponent wants to bolt the Pestermite, that's fine. And if they don't, then I can trade it for Vendilion Click, and then I have Exarch and Snapcaster to keep attacking with Cryptic Commands up in case my opponent does anything. Also, having two of these guys in play mean that my opponent has to fear Splinter Twin at pretty much any time. But I know that my hand supports just trading here. Especially since Deceiver doesn't really die to all that much anyway. Alright, well, having drawn the bolt, I would have not traded, but that's okay. Alright, now I just pass with Cryptics up and try to win the game with these dorks, which I think is plausible. See what my opponent's doing. Getting four, so okay, so it looks like Tarmo Twin then. That's fine. And now I'm not going to do anything on a turn. I'm not randomly, you know, spewing off Cryptics for no reason here. If my opponent taps out for like a Scavenging Ooze or something, I could just Inferno Titan it. Let's go ahead and get a Steam Vents. And untap. Anger of the Gods, not great in this matchup. That is for sure. So I might lose to Deceiver Exarch plus Counterspell here. Pestermite, I don't think is going to beat me because I've got a Lightning Bolt, but Exarch could be annoying. Let's just pass. If my opponent wants to just keep using Lighthouse, that's not the end of the world for me. And since, you know, improving card quality is alright, but I don't think it's horrible. And if my opponent keeps ditching lands, then I might, you know, be able to out-mana them. Opponent's on four cards. I mean, I would have rather had the Snapcaster in play, but I can live. Not tapping out for Inferno Titan. That does not seem like what I want to do here. And, yeah, looks like we're keeping on digging. I wouldn't mind drawing my own Lighthouse so I can cash in this Anger of the Gods. It's also not terrible to draw an extra land and have 8 mana in play, because I can cast double Cryptic here, but we'll see. Spreading Seas on Cascade Bluffs, sure. I've got enough red sources that does not particularly trouble me. Though if my opponent taps down low enough somehow, I could play Inferno Titan, though that doesn't seem super likely either. Draw. Alright, Remand's good. Don't mind having that. And I'm not going for any sort of combo because I don't have capability. Lightning Bolt, sure. I'll let you get Snapcaster here. Because I want to be able to remand the Lightning Bolt. I hope my opponent blocks before casting Lightning Bolt here. Oh yes, this is much better for me. That's actually not the order you want to do things. You're much better off bolting first, seeing it resolves, then deciding whether to block. I mean, obviously my opponent might fight over it. Yeah, this is the one from the graveyard. Alright, let's remand that. And if my opponent has remand, then I can just replay my own remand. And if my opponent has a Pestermite or Exarch, I can just Cryptic to counter it. If opponent has a second Lightning Bolt. Let's see, so if I Cryptic the second Bolt, because this lets me use a Cryptic when my opponent's relatively tapped out. Alright, I'll go for it then. And if my opponent remands my Cryptic, then I traded, at least got a remand out of my opponent's hand, and now my Deceiver survives, and my opponent can't cast end of turn Pestermite or anything unless they've got Simeon Spirit Guide in their deck. So now things are looking real good. I mean, I've got this blank Anger, but the rest of the cards in my hand are pretty relevant. Inferno Titan, maybe not super relevant, but an opponent's only on two cards in hand. One card in hand. All right, and does not use Tech Edge. Playing the land and you have a Desolate Lighthouse in play is interesting. Let's just pass the turn. I can maybe go for, I can go for a split. If I had a land, I could probably go for a Splinter Twin with Cryptic Command backup. But I think I'd rather just now wait and then end of turn, or before combat rather. Let's Deceiver the Tarmogoyf here. And I'm ready to start some fights over this because I've got a Twin in hand. I actually can potentially outrace my opponent. I guess Tarmogoyf does a lot more than Deceiver Exarch, but let's see, do I want a Cryptic? I could Cryptic bouncing the Tarmogoyf. That might actually be fine. Let's see, what's the advantage of that? The advantage of that is I get to attack my opponent at a 9. to cast Splinter Twin with just Remand up instead of Cryptic. That doesn't seem like what I wanted to. Ooh, Desolate Lighthouse. That would have been awesome earlier, but still pretty good. So I think I just attack now. I don't think I need to go for the Twin quite yet. Opponent's on two cards in hand. I really want to Lighthouse this Anger of the Gods away. I'm also getting kind of close to bolting my opponent out. I mean, Inferno 10 is obviously a little expensive, but it does bolt the opponent. All right, so let's just pass the turn. I'd rather use Cryptic and Desolate Lighthouse this turn. All right, so I'm just going to use that. And cash in Anger of the Gods for basically anything. And if opponent has Twin plus Exarch or something like that, then, you know, more power to them. And if the opponent has Twin or Exarch plus a Counterspell and then draws a Twin, that's, I mean, obviously that's pretty bad for me, but I think otherwise I'm looking alright here. Alright, so now we're Lighthousing. And I think I'm just going to pass. I think I can afford to take 5 here. Or discarded Electrolyze, interesting. Now I think I'm just going to fire off the Cryptic end of turn. Cataxian Probe. I could, in response, let's see, I could Counterspell and return Tarmogoyf. It actually seems fine, and then if I get something, you know, gets disrupted here, then I get to, on my next turn, maybe cast Splinter Twin plus Remand. I want to keep my opponent from having too many cards in hand. So now, I think I go for it. A second Remand would be pretty awesome. Ooh, second Bolt's kind of interesting. I could just cast Inferno Titan if it resolves double Bolt my opponent. Nah. Let's cast an Exarch here, or rather a Twin on my Exarch here, and I've got Remand up and double Bolt. If I get Remanded, I'm probably just replaying the Twin, and if I... opponent's casting using Desolate Lighthouse? Okay, well that's probably not a good sign. Alright, well, that worked, even though I had some main deck things which weren't great. I don't know how EFro found room for all these. Alright, let's take Inferno Titans and one that out. Twisted Image is actually okay, because Spell Scout often comes in. I mean, you want all the counters. Potentially bring in Relic to make Tarmogoyf worse. It's a little tricky, because you don't want to make your own Snapcasters worse. But the opponent has Snapcasters, too. Actually, so let's see. Do I want to take out Lightning Bolts? Do I want to take out... I mean, Lightning Bolt seems... Or Electrolyte seems better than Lightning Bolt, because Bolt... I mean, Bolt's cheap, but Bolt also doesn't kill the Deceiver, and they both kill Pestermite. So I think I can take out a couple Bolts. And do I want to take out the Twisted Images? I kind of like the Twisted Images. They seem better, because they also cycle at the very worst. Maybe I could take out one of the Splinter Twins, since the game's going to go kind of long, and I don't anticipate necessarily winning that way. I guess if I'm taking out the Inferno Titans, it's going to be a little tougher. Maybe I put in like one Inferno Titan. Inferno Titan sounds kind of like gas. All right, let's play the Inferno Titan. Maybe we don't need all these Lightning Bolts. Actually, maybe I'll just take out one Twisted Image instead. All right.